In today's video, we are going to learn how to design our own tiki mask. And for that, knowing tiki mask and its history is extremely important. We will know a few key features about tiki mask to make sure that we are able to include them in our designs. And as you can see, that the tiki masks belong to Polynesian culture. They are carved out of wood and they are also used in ancient worship, guarding and protecting homes and temples to protect from evil spirits for fertility. Often carved on a specific trait of a Polynesian gourd, the artist would shape the face to represent that trait. Now, some most important common features we should and we must include while designing our mask are taking care of symmetry, doing mark making to get the wooden texture, add some patterns, make sure that the eyes are hollow, so no eyeballs because these are masks, add some mark making as I told before, make the facial features exaggerated, enlarging them, adding some 3D effect, we will see how to do that, and probably add some leaf decorations if you wish to. To start designing, you will only need a ruler, paper and a pencil. Ruler has to be there to measure your paper and split it into two halves. So I'm taking the center from the top and the bottom so that I can just draw the straight line in the middle of my paper to be able to divide it into halves so that my mask is being symmetrical on both the sides. And as you start drawing, make sure that you're constantly aware or measuring both the sides to make sure it's coming equal. It's easy to go with the face shape first, decide what face shape you like and then go with that. Now I am beginning to add some leafy patterns on the top crown of the mask. And I'm making sure that my lines are symmetrical. So watch this part carefully. Make sure that you are looking at the negative spaces as well to get the symmetry in both the sides. And because the common features of tiki mask includes the exaggeration and enlarging of the facial features, thus we will be making all the facial features bigger than the usual. So you can see I'm making the nose, which is a lot bigger, and I'm going to do the same with the eyes and the mouth as well. So this was all we needed for designing our mask. This was the part 1 of the video. In the part 2, we will learn how to add mark making, to add the wooden texture to our masks. And then in the third video, we will see how to add watercolors to make it look more woody. Thank you for watching.